you're a new developer, I'd recommend starting your own YouTube channel and just uploading videos of you coding. Then you can go back through and hear your voice and see the ways that you actually process the ideas that you're trying to express. When you're working on specific problems like lead code, or maybe a small take-home assignment from a company that you're applying to, it doesn't necessarily reflect the opinions that you have or the ways that you generate ideas. So having a method where you can actually make sure where they create ideas, it doesn't necessarily reflect the opinions that you have or the ways that you generate ideas. So having a method where you can actually make sure that you're keeping track of your own progress, and you can actually see the ways that the code base changes over time. You can actually see the way to actually make sure that you generate ideas. It doesn't necessarily reflect the opinions that you have or the ways that you generate ideas. So having a method where you can actually make sure that you're keeping track of your own progress, you can actually see the ways that the code base changes over time, I think is very helpful. I'd also recommend getting into Git as soon as possible. Then you can actually associate those videos with specific commits and see how they work in the long term. You can go back and look at the commits and say, okay, so I was trying to do this at this point, and this is how the code base has changed since. And that gives you a better feel for the ways that you express ideas with the language that you have access to. Another thing that I would really recommend is to have two relatively distinct projects going on at once. I know it might seem overwhelming at first, and you might not necessarily want to switch between them too much, but it really helps understand you're not going to be able to keep both code bases exactly in your mind the way that you remember them. So I guess the advice there is to come up with a way that you can step away from one code base for a while, then return to it and see how the code looks when you have a fresh set of eyes. Code that I wrote a while ago often feels less quality if I return to it and try to do the same things. Bad code comes from a lot of different places. project where you don't feel pressured to do anything in a specific way or along a specific timeline can be super helpful for understanding what you consider bad code versus necessary code. Personally, I think the industry encourages some bad coding practices by incurring a lot of technical debt before actually considering architecture. I generally prefer to have a strong architecture solution that allows me to incrementally change the amount of technical debt, ideally towards reducing it. There's a lot of pressure from external places to add as many features as possible, but those don't necessarily translate into tangible improvements for a specific product. Having these projects where you don't feel pressured to do anything specific, like accomplishing a goal is a good thing to do, but understanding your relationship to a space is a lot more important when you're starting off especially. Then when you get a software engineering job, you can see how those compare to the ways that other people do it. The main thing, I guess, there is to be flexible, because every single company uses similar language to describe oftentimes very difficult things. Also, the language that you use to communicate with yourself and to communicate with other developers is often different than the ways that your manager might understand the ideas that you have. So reporting yourself and having two different projects where you have to try to reform the context, revisit the things that you were trying to do, maybe explain them, I think is a pretty helpful direction